Well, I made the mistake. You know, a lot of times when you're by yourself, well, I'm sorry, I cut myself off, actually. You know, when you're running everything, audio, video, and everything is coming at you, it's a little difficult sometimes. You make mistakes. So I just made a mistake, and I hit the wrong button. And I shut my stream off, so I had to reboot it. Well, anyhow, I wanted to say happy birthday, of course, to Allison Fisher. I mean, she's one of the most special people, obviously, in our industry. I can't think of anybody, really, that's made more of an impact. When she first came over to the United States, as I was saying, her first stop, her first pro event, I believe, was the event at Boston Billiards. And I met her at Boston Billiards that first time, and actually, this is a snookers trophy. What year was that, anyhow? 1998, that snookers trophy is. What year is this again? 2016, 98. That's 18 years ago at snookers. All right, anyhow, this is the picture I took with Allison. And this was her first visit to the United States that I can remember, in her first pro event. And I've had this picture ever since. I actually had hair back then, and I wasn't heavy. But this is it, her and me at Boston Billiards. And it was the first time her playing in a pro event, I believe. And this is long before Karen, of course. Although Karen's first stop also was here in the Boston area. I think back then, of course, Boston Shorty was around, and we had a lot of billiards. We played a lot of billiards, and Boston Shorty, that's all he played, billiards in one pocket. Anyhow, let me open up the chat, say hi to my friends. Let's get in there and see what's going on. Okay. What's with the reducing of the Moscone Cups points for that even event this weekend? Because they didn't get a full field. That's BS. Points should stay whatever they were supposed to be regardless. Prize money may be reduced, but not the points. I gotta tell you, Linda, and I hope you're feeling well, I totally agree with that. 32 players, it should not qualify for Moscone Cup points, actually. It's too small a field. And the added is too small. Prize money was very low. Although I have not seen what the payoffs were. I have no idea. But if they had a full field, and it was 3,000 added, which we know it wasn't, it would have been a nice, you know, first place would have been over $3,000, of course. And I heard it was 3,100, but my intellect tells me that it was probably maybe $1,000. It's very low. It's definitely too low for Moscone Cup points. Having said that, they had 128 players at the Mets Tour that Oscar won, but should we be giving Moscone Cup points to events that are handicapped? I don't believe we should. I really don't. Because whether you win it, lose it, or whatever, you're up against a lot of weak players. And that's not good for your, you know, I mean, like if you win a Euro Tour, You know, I don't know if the Euro Tour is handicapped or not, but I'm almost positive it's not. That makes sense. But winning an event that's handicapped, meaning you're spotting or getting spotted for that matter, because, you know, when you look at the event in New York, the amateur event added 2,000. So shouldn't that have been a Moscone Cup event because it was amateur? Doesn't matter because the other tournament was amateur too. Any handicap tournament is an amateur event. So it's a little tricky, you know, no question about that. No bar tables, no handicaps. I agree with that, absolutely. I don't think it should be on bar tables. You're not going to be playing on bar tables. Now, if you were playing on bar tables, okay. And if you were playing with handicap, I would say the handicap would be okay. But if you're not, then it isn't okay. You know, so, I mean, it's a tricky situation because although we have a lot of pool being played right across the country, whether it be on the West Coast, whether it be in the Midwest, wherever, down south, there's a lot of pool being played. I mean, the numbers of entries in these events is unbelievable. In New York, there's 128 players in that amateur event. Now, when you take 128 players in the amateur event, and then you look at the pro event, and the pro event is 32 players. Well, if you put 32 next to 128, let's face it, that's four times. Four times 32 is 128. You basically have 25% entries only if you hold just the pro event. Now, I didn't even think they'd get 32, to be honest with you. They got a few players there that surprised me that they would come up to play. Sean Wilkie and Brandon. It's very expensive. If you're going to play in a low-priced event, you're not going to make out too well. But if you got a backer, it's not costing you nothing. You can chase the Moscone Cup points. But yeah, I appreciate you bringing that point out, Linda, about the points. I read that myself. And to be honest with you, I talked about that prior to it. I said, how can you give that? You know, those points can't be very valuable. This is one of the problems that I think Mike Deshane's going to have down the road on points if he doesn't do the travel scene, which I don't believe he's going to. It doesn't make sense. He's not kind of that kind of rogue guy. He likes to be at home with his friends, and I'm not sure he's wants to be on the road for a month or two, like a lot of these guys are doing. They're on the road. I mean, look at Warren, Sky, and Dennis. How long are they away from their families? It's unbelievable, really, the amount of time that they're away. Now, I want to continue to badger the fact that we need to get on YouTube. I hope Upstate starts to get a channel on, get AZB on YouTube for live. I got to tell you, the difference between how many people are watching on YouTube and Ustream, it's a joke. It's almost 100-1. If you do a live show, a really good one on YouTube where you got a good tournament, let's say the Turning Stone Casino, you're potentially going to get 20,000 viewers, not 200, you know? I'm talking 20,000. I mean, it's a big, it's 100-1 in who watches YouTube and who watches Ustream. People go to YouTube for everything. People go to Ustream for nothing. I don't know how many people actually go to Ustream unless we get a link that says there's a tournament being done on Ustream. That's the only reason you're going to go there. So I'm trying to bring everybody over to YouTube, which has the same software that you're going to use. It's the same format platform, Wirecast, I believe, And I just think that YouTube is such a winner, and we're missing out. We're missing out because all we're getting are the pool players, the real us, people that are really into the game to the crazy level. But on YouTube, you're gonna get so many different more people. They sign in. It's just a lot better. I don't know what the reason is that everybody went to Ustream. I know I did too, but I want to go to YouTube. I can do a YouTube, live show, but it's only going to be for 15 minutes. So if you did not follow me on YouTube, I appreciate it if you would go to YouTube, put in Marty Herman, and follow me on YouTube. And when I get 100 on YouTube, I'm going to do all my shows on YouTube. We'll have a nice chat over there. And my live show, I'll make more consistent as well on scheduling, because a lot of people never see my live show. They always catch the recording, because sometimes I'm on at 7 in the morning, a lot of times. A lot of times I'm on a little bit after 8 o'clock. Sometimes I'm on at 5 a.m. I'm just recording the shows, not expecting live traffic. And sometimes I'm on like now. I mean, I did not know I was coming on till 5, till 5 minutes before we set up shop here today. So that's why it's very difficult. Now, if I stayed on for 20 hours, like most of these long tournaments do, well, of course, I'm going to get all the viewers. But I don't do that. I'm an hour, hour and a half tops, and I'm out of town. So, I want to go to YouTube. I want to be on live. I want to be on a consistent schedule. And first, I got to get 100 followers. So if you haven't hit me up over there, please do. You can get to see a couple of matches I played back in the 80s and the 90s, and I still have some to upload as well. There's a big event coming up, and it's going on. We don't want to miss this one. It's a biggie. It's a $275,000 guaranteed event, and those are the kind of events you want to be in. Let me give you the exact, I might throw the link up for you in the chat, because this is the really most important events of the season. Dave Knight, of course, always posting up, and we appreciate that, Dave. It's the World Pool Billiard Association, also known as the WPA. And it's in Kuwait, of course, and that is the World Championship, and it is $275,000 prize money. That's pretty good money. That's pretty good money. So let's get the dates. It'll be 9-ball. They reached an agreement. Let me read it to you. Please be advised that we have reached an agreement with people in Kuwait to host the Kuwait 9-Ball Open for men. The Kuwait 9-Ball Open. So it's not the World Championship. It is the Kuwait 9-Ball Open for men. September 6th to the 17th in September this year. This event will be a WPA ranking event for a field of 128 players and will offer $275,000 in prize money. It is hoped that the event will run back-to-back with the Men's 9-Ball World Championship in Qatar, which is from the 19th to the 30th in September, proposed, which would be a great benefit for the players, especially the international ones who could play in both big events for not much more than the regular price of one air ticket. More details will be announced soon, and that's in regards by Ian Anderson, who is the president of the WPA. So there you got it. What's happened is Kuwait has secured the payment for the WPA. And it's funny, but Qatar has yet to make payment. They're on a 5-year contract at Qatar, and they've been cutting the prize money down over there at that World Championship. And that's September 19th to the 30th, which is just 2 weeks after this other event in Kuwait. So yeah, I mean, you don't want to be paying twice to go over there, folks. So yeah, if you're playing in that Kuwait tournament and you're traveling, you got to enter that Qatar tournament too. And you might need an invite. And I believe you can get an invite if you show you're interested in going. A lot of the top players do get invites, and they elect not to go. So you don't see them. And if you don't see them, it's not because they didn't get invited. It's because they elected not to go. So if you play full-time, like Mike Deshane, for example, he could probably get an invite. I would think the man, Ivan Lee, is doing the invites. It used to be Jerry Forsyth, but I believe now it's Ivan Lee. But we'll see. But anyhow, yeah, anybody that wants to play in that World Championship or that tournament in Kuwait, your chances of getting invited to that are excellent if you inquire right now. If you're a player that wants to participate in the WPA high rankings, Oscar and a few other, Rodney Morris, you know, and we don't see them going over there. But maybe this year. Maybe this year. We'll see. But other news locally, you know, I've been waiting, and everybody's been waiting for Steve Wynn or the Wynn Casino to open up. It's really been a comedy of lawsuits that just keep going on and on and on. And Wynn Everett implements a hiring freeze. Wynn cancels all hiring fees until the waterfront permit appeal by the city of Somerville is sorted out. And what's happened is Wynn Resort construction has been put on hold pending a Somerville appeal, and Somerville's the town they're building in. It's unbelievable. Unbelievable, unbelievable. Anyhow, let's talk a little bit about the casino over in Plain Ridge, where I'll be a couple of months, and what's going on over there. They weren't doing so well after they opened up, and now they're starting to make a little bit of a comeback over there, and they're still up in the air. They don't know which direction they're going in. I know people that go over there, and they didn't think much of it. So who knows? I also want to give a big shout out to anybody local yokels. We've got an event here in Norwood, Mass, Workman's Hall. It's unbelievable. I can't believe that they're actually going to have a 500 added event. That is unbelievable. That is really unbelievable. 500 added. The entry fee is like $20, $30, $40, depending on your class. But I guess you're playing even, and it's $500 added, and it's not that much to get in. There'll be no green fees whatsoever. I believe Mr. Dion, Mark Dion, is going to get his fees, membership fees. So let me read the flyer. Here it is. New England Nine Ball Series, February 28th. It's a one-day event. Double elimination, winner breaks, race to your handicap. What is that? Seasonal membership, $25. Day pass, $10. Entry fees. Here we go. Pros are allowed and opens. they're gonna cost you $45, okay? $45, that's peanuts and crackers, I like that. Double A and A plus, or A and A minus, or AA, whatever, Alcoholics Anonymous, that's gonna cost you $40. Now, if you're a B plus, a B minus, or a B poo-poo, you're gonna pay $35. Anything in the B's, anything in the C's, C plus, C minus, $30. And even the D's get in for $25. I like this, okay? There's a little bit of a dress code, no t-shirts, no tank tops. College shirts must be worn, must look presentable. Oh, okay, I like that. Don't forget, it's at, unbelievable, Workman's Hall, 99 Wilson Street, Norwood, Mass. I gotta tell you, that's close to me. It's very close to me. And certainly, I could play in it, but most likely I won't. Although it's a nice little place, fun place. I don't know if my competing days are, who knows, maybe I will go. Ernie's trying to push Ernie to go, not me. But I'd like to see Ernie go. But yeah, I mean, why not? It's a measly, it's so inexpensive, and it's local, and 500 added. How can it be 500 added? That's unbelievable, you know? Now, it's not 500 added contingent upon 75 million entries. It's 500 added, I don't care if six people show up. This guy over there, he's really, he's no cheapskate. He don't want nothing big, but he, you know, that's pretty good. You're adding 500, you know, for the local yokels, if you're anywhere around. You know, you should play in it. And even if you're not local, it's a one-day event. Drive up from Connecticut. Drive up from Rhode Island. Drive up from, drive up from anywhere, to be honest with you. That's, you know, it's worth chasing. What's it going to cost you if you're not a pro? Cost you $40. $40, $10 membership for the day, $50, 500 added, 10 to 1 on the money. And it's going to be, you know, it's not going to be the strongest field in history. Maybe Mike DeShane will be there. I mean, it's close to him. It's as close to him as it is to me. So, yeah, pretty interesting. Chris Brooks says he's going to Boston this weekend. Maybe he's going. Maybe he's going to the tournament, Chris Brooks. You know. But, you know, Linda and Ernie and a few others can stop over there. Jesus, Linda, you get in for 25, I'll back you. How's that? You kidding me? Let's get the cheese over there. But yeah, that's what's going on locally, so that should be fun. You know, we see so much of the Southwest Qs, and the pricing on them is just absolutely, it's out of this world, I mean. So here's a Southwest that Greg's selling, and he's asking $4,500 bucks. I don't know. I don't know. That's just a lot of money. That's all I know. That is a lot of money. I mean, I don't know. I mean, those Southwest Qs are nice, but when you talk about that kind of money, there's an awful lot of them for sale. Between the prices of $3,500 and $5,500, and I'm not sure, you know, look it. It's great, you know, it's a great cue, but When you start talking that kind of money, that to me is quite a burden. And that's just too much money. Let's just put it that way. And no trades. I mean, that's like trying to sell a brand new car and telling people no trades. I always accept trades. I may not accept the deal because it may not be worth it. But I definitely, I never say no to trades because people have a lot of money in some of these queues and you can end up with something really nice. I actually got something really nice right here in trade. I would not sell this queue for, this queue is worth $10,000 to me. I look at the Southwest and then I look at this queue and I say, are you serious? Are you serious? Oh well. A lot of suckers out there. I don't know if you call them suckers or whatever, but I know one thing. I ain't got $4,500 to put into a Southwest queue. I ain't got $3,500 to put into a Southwest queue. And if I do $3,000, I'm not sure I'd go down that road either. You can get a lot more queue and a lot better queue elsewhere. There's some great queue builders out there, and I just, at this point, I wouldn't go near Southwest queues at those prices. And nobody sold more and knows more about those queues than me. They can know as much as me, but knowing more, I doubt it. Spent a lot of time with Jerry, Laurie, at the shop, Joe Lawrence, sold many. David Kirschenbrock, when he was up in Binghamton, bringing those 12 to 14, 6 to 14 queues every couple of months up at Binghamton, New York, going up there and grabbing them. It's just been a long journey with Southwest. Of course, back then, those queues were only $90, $160 with two shafts. Also, the new Southwest, I mean, I don't get it. You know, who's building them and why is it getting that money? It's just mind-boggling. There's nothing going on with the queue. You know, although when you do finish the queue in Las Vegas in the desert, you're going to get a great finish. And that great finish is going to make that queue a lot tighter. Any kind of splice queue is going to be a lot tighter. The finish is going to be good. So that helps in the hitting capacity quite a bit. I don't know, that's an awful lot of money. Now you go over to Taiwan and they're paying more than that for the queue. Having said that, Mike Duchesne won the tournament at Snookers with the Southwest, the one he just bought. So I thought that was pretty interesting as well. Boy, it's been heartbreaking, a lot of stuff, but, you know, there's a lot of fun stuff going on, too, and there's a lot of heartbreaking stuff going on, but till it happens to you, because overnight, you don't know. You don't know what can happen. Your life changes overnight, and then you'll be all right. No, I don't know if I'll be all right. No idea. Thank you so much for your time, and we'll see you tomorrow, Thursday. I might be on early in the morning. That's most likely what will happen, around 9 o'clock, maybe. In the meantime, have a good night, and thank you so much for spending your time here at Herman University, where we never lose, because we're always learning.